r/AskReddit by Robotainment. The 2010s decade will be over in 4 months. What do you think people will remember this decade for? The social media explosion. And the 20s will be the implosion. We're already sick of ourselves. The rise of the smartphone. Everyone has access to the internet and can voice their opinion towards the world at any moment with all the negative effects that it brings. In my humble opinion, this is the biggest one. The iPhone came out in what, 2007? It was a solid year or two before you had traction there. Now, phones have pretty much replaced most people's home computers for menial tasks. I don't like this realization. The 90s are soon 30 years ago. Real headlines trying to outdo The Onion. That's never going to happen. The Onion headline about the president causing a controversy by drawing on a map with a Sharpie still cracks me up. My generation is going to be known for wanting to die in memes. Guess we can replace generation for decade. We're the doomer generation, not the millennials, or maybe that's Gen Z IDK. It's all a mess right now. The meme renaissance. Chapter 7. Memes were the quintessential millennial mode of expression, akin to the hieroglyphics of Egypt and the cuneiform tablets of some early 21st century internet savants populated their Facebook feeds with fan favorites such as lolcats and Philosoraptor. As the trend caught on, memes diversified and developed, getting adopted by such institutions as politics, academia, and postmodern avant-garde. Expressionism as memes became more sophisticated, so too did their influence over society. The charged political landscape ignited a trend of weaponizing them for political use, culminating into the bloody meme wars of 2028. People are gonna reminisce about how good the 2010s were. They may not seem good now, but just wait to see what the 20s have in store for you. Oh no. Social media influences. Netflix streaming. It was available before 2010, but didn't get reliable until after. Swipe dating apps. The word online dating and dating sites are now swapped with the phrases dating apps, Obama, Trump. The death of traditional media. Printed newspapers and periodicals, broadcast television and radio are fading, and while digital music way predates the 2010s, it took until this decade for pop stars to stop selling albums. They aren't tallying CD sales anymore. Fear counting unique streams. The incredible rise of misinformation and irresponsible knee-jerk reaction choices on very serious topics. The horrific turn the Area 51 raid took, resulting in hundreds dead and the unleashing of angry captive aliens upon the world to exact their revenge on humanity. Don't forget the military being defeated by swarms of Naruto runners, leading to new arms limitation treaties banning the use of the Naruto run in any armed conflict. From a video game standpoint, this is the decade of the indie explosion. Esports, battle royales and microtransactions. From a cinematic standpoint, this is the age of superheroes. Comic book movies dominated in the last decade and they are not going anywhere anytime soon. I think we'll eventually look back at superhero movies the way that we look back at cowboy movies. The wild switch from President Obama to President Trump. Say what you want, good or bad, about either of them, but their ways of doing the job are very different in many ways. Edit. Thanks for the gold and silver, whoever you are. You put that very politically neutral. I like it. I'm just hoping that the 20s will be the resurgence of gangster suits, black fedoras, and saying things like, "It'll punch you into mush, see?" And leaning against a street lamp at night, flipping a coin in the air with your thumb. They will remember how great summer 2016 was. Edit. I removed the comma. Edit 2. Wow, my first medal of any kind. Thanks, stranger. People ask me where I'm going to be in 4 months. I don't have 2020 vision jokes. The clown epidemic of 16. That feels like a fever dream we all collectively had. Social media. A great tool horribly mismanaged. Didn't see it here, so I'll mention it. The Syrian civil war and rise and fall of the Islamic State. Shit, the Syrian civil war will still be ongoing next decade, fret not. Depression and memes. But really, I think mental health will be one of the biggest problems going forward, and this is going to be known as the times when it emerged as a problem. Social media, memes, smartphones, Trump. The dress was blue. Laurel. Put that away, you put that comment away. the decade where politics turned into a name-calling shit show where reason is irrelevant. Sports team politics. I think this decade will be remembered for a few big things, at least in the US. Millennials, the name of the game this decade. Millennials were at the center of almost every major cultural conversation, from social media and technology to jobs and the economy, hipsters and smartphones, and gaming systems and trends and Facebook and Instagram, etc, etc. Millennials had the biggest cultural impact of this decade. Obama. Trump. Obama was elected last decade, but most of his term was this decade. He got Bin Laden, passed healthcare, and triggered a whole bunch of people just because he was black. Then Trump really popped up in 2015 for his presidential run. Was it really that long ago? And has been at the forefront of news ever since. Superhero. Everything. 20 MCU movies have been released this decade. Then there are the other Spider-Man movies, the DC Universe movies, Nolan's and Snyder's, as well as countless other movies and shows. Last decade was zombies. This decade is superheroes. Outrage addiction. A YouTuber pointed this out very clearly. He gave the example of the Nike Betsy Ross shoe controversy. He showed how this was a planned incident to increase sales for Nike. Why did Nike come out and basically say, sorry, we are recalling all of the Betsy Ross shoes because Colin Kaepernick thinks they might be offensive even if true? Why not just try and silently recall them, or just make up a simple excuse? Why? Because that Forks incident will cause outrage, which will drive up sales for Nike by the group of people that need to stand up to injustice and get those bad people that oppose this. On the flip side of this is the other companies cashing in on it as well. They are the ones saying, don't put up with this Colin Kaepernick crap. Show him and Nike that you really hate them by buying a Betsy Ross shirt and hat from us. So it sells on both ends and companies are laughing all of the way to the bank. Outrage sells more than ever nowadays. Edit. Here is the link of the video I referenced. www.youtube.com link. The death of brick and mortar and the rise of Amazon Prime. Party rock. 2011 was such a rad time to go to college house parties. Those guys had the quickest retirement of all time. Spending the entire decade thinking last year was 2008. Gangnam Style and Haram. Brexit. Trump as president. #METOO #BLACKLIVESMATTER. Leonardo DiCaprio got an Oscar. I disagree. Brexit will still be going on for another 68 years. The beginning of automation. A ton of jobs are already automated, but this decade was probably the true beginning. From testing driverless cars and drones to entire service industries being replaced by self-service counters, this will truly be the beginning of automated industries. To be fair, it began long, long ago with the Industrial Revolution, but it's a well remember 2010 as the birth of AI automation. Our inability to come together and tackle climate change. Hooray. In historical terms, 50 years from now, it's probably going to be seen as the end of the sixth party system. Endpoint. Wikipedia.org link. In US politics, it was drawing to a close anyway, but I think historians will view the Trump presidency as the era where there was a distinct shift on both sides. An increase in small dollar donations for political candidates, especially on the left. Increasing partisanship between the left and the right. A swing towards progressivism on the left as seen by the rise of Sanders, Warren, and AOC. The slow weakening of the religious right, as evidenced by the willingness of evangelicals to look the other way on their moral purity tests, and the depressingly speedy rise of the nationalist right. The push towards women and minority representation in government. In political terms, the 200s were all about terror. The 2010s are going to be remembered for upending the political landscape. They will remember crazy colored hair trying to dress like people in the 90s, those old iPhones that everyone had and thought were so cool, but look like bricks now, vaping, thick eyebrows, overly photoshopped and facetuned photos back when YouTube actually allowed relatively normal people to become famous. Duck. Lip stabbing haram. I think it might be seen as a time of real change. We legalized gay marriage. A handful of states have legalized marijuana, and whatever your opinion of it is, the #METOO movement has been a big deal. Wait, wait, wait. Last decade wasn't the 90s? Yeah, I lost an entire decade too. Memes and Minecraft. For Europe, it will definitely be the refugee crisis. The 2010s will probably be remembered for as the remake era for Disney. The incest porn. What are you talking about, stepbro? Seriously, the amount of incest porn has gotten to be so overwhelming that I now question the sincerity of anyone who says they are not into that kind of thing. EWW gross, my sister has lost all meaning to me. I'll just say that this is the best question on AskReddit that I've seen yet. Politics in the Western world descending into absolute farce. Not necessarily just the Western world, there was the Arab Spring, South Korea impeached their president, and all the stuff going down in Hong Kong now. Knowing that global warming is going to hit us hard, and doing virtually nothing about it globally. PC and outrage culture culminating into anyone with a conservative view on anything being labeled a Nazi and anyone with a progressive viewpoint labeled a soy boy or communist, all the while an additional 39.25 genders arose out of nowhere, and crazy people want to transition 5-year-olds from one gender to another amidst the absurdity that Trump also became president and constantly tweets with the intelligence of an 8-year-old with bad parents. That's an astonishing number of people you just insulted in one post, I approve. Centrist take of the day, nice. Shitty GECO and progressive commercials. Yeah, GECO commercials were way better in the zeros. This decade has been terrible for insurance commercials. Memes point mass fucking hysteria, and Trump. How stupid it was to get rid of the aux jack on phones. The 2010s will remember it as a decade where everyone went from chill to radicalized in a surprisingly short span of time. Black president, orange president, and Tide Pods. Yeet. I've only been alive 2 decades, so take what I have to say with a grain of salt, but I think this will be remembered as the decade when the physical world was overtaken the online world. Dating is online, classes are online, news is online, and it's about what politicians said online. Presidential campaigns are internet memes, print media and physical music are disappearing, our jobs are being taken by AI, the jobs we have left are done on computers. The cloud knows more data about us than we do. You have to have an email to sign up for anything, and apps are constantly trying to wring more digital data out of us. I know this sounds conspiratorial, personally I'm not against it. I think we just have to find a balance. I was thinking about this compared to last decade, 9/11, Katrina, and financial crisis. This decade seems relatively mild. Like, what was the worst thing to happen? Harvey. I really think, aside from mass shootings and the terrorist attacks that ISIS plagued upon the Middle East and other countries like France and Britain in the mid-2010s, it hasn't been that bad. Like, it hasn't been a pleasant decade, but it's still fine. Trump and everyone obsessing with Trump. Including Trump. The decade where we finally all started to realize global warming is a legit concern, and how it's getting to a point of no return. Hopefully the 2020s will be known as the green decade. Here's hoping. The decade that normalized eating ass. The promulgation of the internet. The 2010s saw the popularity of smartphones, which has revolutionized many industries. The internet is way more a force now than it was pre-2010. Network TV isn't a thing because of the internet. Brick and mortar stores are dying because of the internet. School shootings. The decade Twitter defined politics. The rise of Yao to ban music videos, Gangnam Style point party rock anthem point Despacito point everything Ed Sheeran point PewDiePie. I always think about this, the 80s were defined by optimistic decadence and a neon future. The 90s were a hangover from the 80s, dominated by grunge and grit, led by the freedom fighters and suburban rebel rock. The zeros is when the effects of globalism really started to take hold. Ultimately, I feel like the zeros were a positive time when we experienced a brief utopia of man and machine, which led to a lot of realization, inspiration, and evolution. However, the revolution was somewhat organic, and even though we experienced an economic downturn, the future looked bright. The 10s were plastic. We let a reality TV show host become president. We realized the dystopian future that we read about in books and saw in movies. The boundaries of what is real have been stretched and shattered. The rich are living in a separate reality in their high rises, and the poor are killing each other in the streets. It has been a time of dark hedonism, which I think will result in a following period of enlightenment and return to nature. 10 more years of lost time to fight the climate change crisis. Unfortunately, it looks like the 2020s will be more of the same. Cannabis legalization movement, as a graduate during the economic recession, it's the only real positive thing I remember in the past decade, and the crazy American cultural swing from Obama to Trump. It's the decade when all governments became a joke. The difference of presidency between Obama and Trump, by proxy, the 2016 election. Cancel culture, though, that might be going into 2022. The LGBT movement. The real LGBT movement happened way before this decade. This decade is just when the American federal government got on board. I'm gonna remember the 2010s as my decade of adversity. Some of these years have been the toughest of my life. Hopefully I can look at the 2020s as the best of my life. The optimist take: creeping authoritarianism around the world, growing realization of climate catastrophe, vlogging, influencer, social media pestilence, unhinged culture war zealots and bad faith actors running amok, fracturing societies along dangerous ethnic and ideological lines, dismantling of key tenets of civics, religion, and commerce without offering any viable alternatives, complete loss of faith in the politicians, business and spiritual elites, to improve our lot in life, more isolation, more anger, more disagreement, more total disinformation, more hate, more pixels, less understanding, total collapse of trust in the total victory of marketing and advertising against humanity, growing realization we're all trapped in a dystopian hellscape none of us asked for. People getting extremely triggered or forcing their personal views opinions onto anyone who is near, to the point where it becomes cringe or gives it a bad reputation. For example, the extreme need to let people know your thoughts on vaccines, abortion, vegans, feminists and so on. While there has always been rational debating on anything and everything, giving the spotlight to people who are either not actually educated on the subject or irrational and angry because it is entertaining, has led a lot of stupid people to spread hate and misinformation. Point 2010 from my opinion is, when people started thinking it would be beneficial to force everyone to put up with irrational and aggravated public disturbances, when in most cases, aggressive or uneducated protests make whatever you fight for a total joke. Rather than doing something useful for whatever shit you're upset about, these idiots have spent their time causing a scene and ultimately ruining a lot of legitimate work progress from others. Corruption and the decline of Western civilization that was started in the 1980s and completed by this decade. I wouldn't call it a decline at all. Civil rights and the lowest rates of violent crimes in centuries is awesome. Depression. The 247 Trump news cycle. The decade the 21st century really started. The decade that the basic political divide shifted from government should do more versus government should do less, to open society versus closed society. When women started abusing inequality by making false rape claims and getting away with their own very real sexual harassments. People believing vaccines are fake. I really don't like this realization. The birth of virtual reality, and in particular the start of the social VR revolution. Blatant and intentional shallowness. Good God, this entire thread is ripe for a Iran generation. Everyone getting offended by everything always. The wet fart that was Game of Thrones season 8. It feels like a wasted decade. Hopefully the 20s will be better. It feels undefined, kind of a continuation of the 200s, except with less style. The Marvel Cinematic Universe will be a major bookmark in the 2010s media identity. Point 2010 to 2019 saw 21 films and 27 seasons of 11 shows on 2 cable channels and 2 streaming services that have canonical events with each other. Avengers Endgame is the highest grossing movie ever. Even if you're not a fan, chances are slim you live through the 10s. Without hearing about the Avengers or Iron Man. The death of Osama bin Laden like 911. Most people remember what they were doing when they heard he had been killed by Navy SEALs. The Arab Spring and the Syrian Civil War, and the migrant crisis that occurred from that. American culture getting more liberal, with gay marriage being legalized nationally, and recreational marijuana being legal in 11 states and Washington DC, and medical marijuana legal in 22 states. The opiate crisis, the rise of smartphone and tablet usage, all the amazing television shows, the rise of neo-nationalism, the election of Donald Trump, Brexit, the culture wars, and decline of traditional media. Definitely Trump and the rejection of globalism, increasing political tensions, rise of the openly socialistic left, and rise of the openly nationalistic right. Considering the U.S. doesn't have much tank in the gas, this will probably be the decade historians point to as the prelude to the second American Civil War and breakup of the Union. I highly doubt there will ever be a second American Civil War. All states are far too reliant on one another for basic goods and services. That separating without years or decades worth of preparation time is a recipe for utter disaster. The only state that could reasonably break away from the Union and be alright due to its size, natural resources and oil is Texas, and only because Texas could get by selling its oil to other countries and make up for what it lacks. Most states are too reliant on subsidies and grants to be able to pull away. Others need the natural resources from the subsidy states to be able to properly function. See California and water. The states more or less crippled their own ability to break apart and still maintain the status quo, which, if I've learned anything about Americans, is that they hate anything that inconveniences them with a burning passion and will fight to the death to prevent it from happening. Mass shootings. Im not even from you, sir, and that's what I'll probably remember. Im still traumatized over Sandy Hook. Social media. Definitely. The tragedy. I was born in the late 90s, but my high school years really encompass the early 10s. When I think back to the things I remember happening in the world while I was in high school, the Boston Marathon bombing, Sandy Hook, San Bernardino, and a local shooting. This was at the beginning of the modern news shift and national panic, at least in my mind. I'm probably wrong, and I just remember sitting in the parking lot after school in 2013, the day of Sandy Hook, being stunned. You're not wrong, but the 2010s won't own it. The turning point tragedies still come in Oklahoma City 1995, WTC 1993, look it up, and 2001, and Columbine 199. But the madness has been around for a long, long time. Check out Bath City 1927. Worse than Sandy Hook in terms of deaths. Social media. Crap music. Maroon 5. Ariana Grande. Jonas Brothers. Mumble rap. Political dysfunction and unrest. 0.154398 genders. None of the artists you shared are good examples of 2010 music. Maroon 5 was way more popular in the 200s and early 2010s. They had maybe 3 popular songs after Payphone. Ariana Grande got popular in the last 2 years and she's a great singer, and I would say most people think her music is alright. But definitely not crap. Jonas Brothers were inactive till last year, so IDK why you mentioned them. A more accurate list of defining artists spans of 2010s would be Adele, Ed Sheeran, Drake, Imagine Dragons, Bruno Mars. Mumble rap never became mainstream. List and 2 on the radio won awards with the exception of Future, Lil Uzi Vert, and Migos, who only had a few really popular songs. As someone who anticipated this since the decade started when I was in 8th grade, a few things. 0.1 Social media boom. While introduced in the 200s, it was until this decade that Facebook, Twitter and Instagram became the social media giants that we know now. Snapchat also grew in popularity around 2013, and some tertiary platforms like TikTok, Yakayak, and Vine. Tinder and Bumble became the premier dating apps. Increase a path. A simultaneous concern by many over privacy, ease of access has allowed events such as the Arab Spring to come to fruition, as well as so many other social media movements. The 24-hour news cycle morphed into a second-by-second basis coming from millions of sources. 0.2 Rise of streaming. Hollywood has become dominated by major franchises, following the growing trend in the 200s, leaving smaller films to find new audiences on streaming like Netflix, Hulu, etc. Third had a resurgence in 2010 to 2012 after Avatar's success, but shortly fizzled out after Marvel. Movies dominated the decade, guaranteeing a degree of quality with each movie. Television and binge-watching shows on streaming has led to more buzz on shows like Breaking Bad, Game of Thrones, etc. 3. Hip-hop becomes the dominant genre and artists become more independent. The failure of rock and pop music to innovate has allowed hip-hop to grow vastly in popularity, requiring only production and vocals. The genre has become very accessible to newcomers on platforms like SoundCloud and Bandcamp, hosting many new artists, filling the void MySpace left camps such as TDE, Odd Future, ASAP Mob, along with so many other acts, have been able to gain followings on sites like YouTube, opening the door for many new artists to be able to penetrate the mainstream and gain followings. Exposure. Physical media in general has been on the decline, with most listening to music on streaming platforms like Spotify. 4. Games as a service, microtransactions, etc. Free-to-play games and user-shared content grows in popularity, with games like Fortnite and Minecraft respectively. Games like Destiny offer games as a service models. Microtransactions find their way into many games, etc. Fortnite. Trump. Literally every political figure and celebrity being exposed as a pedophile, rapist, whatever, C-class. Here's a slideshow of these mysterious photos that humans from the 2010s would share and edit repeatedly. Apparently they called them memes. The generation that massively contracted cancer from smartphones and jewels. The last few years before the ice all melted, the ending of any sort of privacy whatsoever, either, provided that there is not a massive internet crash in the future. This would probably be the decade hailed as a massive step in history and documentation, because we would have surveillance footage and social media from literally every person on the planet, and could put it all together to tell the entire story of this generation. Loss of freedom of speech. The push toward so much political correctness that it ended comedy, creativity, and independent thought entitled women and millennials desiring equality, but really wanting more than their fair share. A desire to enter racism that really only seemed to make everything worse. Selfies being fake on Instagram. Veganism. A push to save the planet that we have been intent on destroying for quite some time, but realistically, the only people who can afford to save it are involved in the corporations actively destroying it. The death of personal opinions and meritocracy due to the rise of PC culture. Age of remakes in Hollywood. Nerds become trendy kids. Streaming binge watching. Brexit. Internet creating artists. Funko Pops. Edm Pop Trap. Ariana Grande and Manchester. Netflix and chill. By the way, I'll tag you on Insta hashtag. This decade will be remembered for the explosion of social media, how we became more accepting of LGBT people, how people could make music without needing a record label, and how politics became more volatile. Social justice warriors. Tide Pods. The global rise of right-wing populism. Minecraft. Obama's social media memes been laden. Gangnam style Harlem Shake. Trump. That's how I will remember the 2010s. Culture war. Considering the last 4 years, Trump, the media has sensationalized the crap out of him to the point where it bet hell be very overrepresented in people's minds. The absolute inability of the urban liberal bourgeoisie to come to terms with any significant political defeat is the phenomenon I'm dying to see analyzed by serious scholars. I believe the answer is ultimately theological. Edit. A good analysis of why the urban liberal bourgeoisie lose. www.youtube.com link. Memes and getting offended. Like and subscribe for good luck, you handsome gentleman.